Good morning, students. Till now, we have studied the kinds of pollination, how different pollinating agents help in pollination. Now, we'll study how self-pollination is not preferred and cross-pollination is preferred. For this, some outbreeding devices are present in the plants. So, majority of plants produce hermaphrodite flowers. Hermaphrodite means bisexual flowers. And pollen grains are likely to come in contact with the stigma of the same flower. Continued self-pollination results in inbreeding depression, that it decreases vigor and vitality, and variations doesn't occur, and in the meantime evolution doesn't occur. So plants doesn't prefer self-pollination, they go for cross-pollination. For this, different outbreeding devices are present to ensure cross-pollination. First one is dichogamy. Dichogamy means that anthers and stigma mature at different times in a bisexual flowers. Means just like protoandry, anthers mature earlier than stigma of the same flower. So their pollen grains become available to stigma of the older flowers. Then protogyny means stigma mature earlier so that they get pollinated before the anthers of same flower develop pollen grains. So means that anther and stigma mature at different times so that self-pollination doesn't occur. This process is called dichogamy. Next one is decliny. Decliny means unisexuality. Flowers are unisexual, so that self-pollination is not possible. Plant may be monoecious, bearing both male and female flowers, just like castor, maize, or dioecious, bearing male and female flowers on different plants. We have done earlier in the first chapter, example is mulberry, papaya. So it means that monoecious nature prevents autogamy, but not gynogamy. So dioecious nature prevents both autogamy and gynogamy. So you all know these terms very well, autogamy, gynogamy, xenogamy. In the previous slide, we have all done this. Now next, outbreeding devices, self-sterility. Self-sterility means that it's a genetic mechanism. Pollen grains of a flower don't germinate on the stigma of the same flower due to the presence of similar self-sterile gene, S1, S3 in crystal. When it means that in flowers, one gene is present, that is S1 or S3 in pistil or in pollen grains, which is a genetic mechanism which doesn't allow the self-pollination. Next is heterostyly. Heterostyly means there are two or three types of flowers with different heights of styles. Means stigma height and anther stamen height are different, and they are not able to do self-pollination. So in this example, there is triheterostyly, diheterostyly, different examples are also there present. Means they are at the different height so that they don't do self-pollination. In this slide, we are learning pollen-pistil interaction. So the pistil has the ability to recognize the pollen, whether it is of right type or it is of wrong type. If it is of right type, the pistil accepts the pollen and promotes post-pollination events. So this is achieved by a dialogue is present between the pollen and pistil, by which chemical components of the pollen by the ovary are secreted, allow the pollen grain to secrete a make a pollen tube, so that the male nucleus which are present inside the pollen grain can be transferred to the towards the ovule. So this you will do in later in the practicals, that when we take vinsha, balsam, pea, chickpea, the pollen grains of these flowers will have some sugar, sucrose plus boric acid, some quantity of that, and then we'll keep it for some time, and then you will see that pollen grains germinated, pollen tube, which you can do this with after when the practical class will be there. So in this slide we are watching, it's a longitudinal section of flower showing growth of pollen tube. Now pollen tube through the style goes inside the ovule, and as we know that pollen grain has, in some plants pollen grain are shed at two celled condition, vegetative cell and degenerative cell, we have done it earlier, and in some plants the pollen grain is shed at the three celled condition. Pollen tube carries two male gametes and one vegetative cell. So in this regard we'll study that the egg present inside the ovule and the male germ cell, they will unite together and form a zygote, and this process is called syngamy, means the fusion of male germ cell and egg, it's called syngamy, and the fusion of another male nucleus and the polar nuclei which are present inside the central cell, it's called triple fusion. So syngamy and triple fusion both collectively are called double fertilization. So this is the unique process which is present only in the flowering plants, syngamy and triple fusion, and then double fertilization takes place. So we'll study about post fertilization events in the next slide. We can do artificial hybridization also. In artificial hybridization is the one of the major approaches of crop improvement program. In such crossing experiments, it's important to make sure that only the desired pollen grains are used for pollination, and stigma is protected from contamination from unwanted pollen grains. This is achieved by emasculation and bagging technique. Emasculation means if a flower plant bears bisexual flowers, then removal of anthers from the flower bud before the anther dehiscence using a forcep, this step is known as emasculation. Now emasculated flowers are covered with a paper bag, butter paper bag, and then this process is called bagging. And when the stigma of bagged flowers attains receptivity, mature pollen grains collected from anthers of the male parent are dusted on the stigma, and the flowers are rebagged, and the fruits allowed to develop. This kind of hybridization is called artificial hybridization. So we'll study next topic. Double fertilization in brief and post fertilization events in the next class.